You've been thinking it, but you haven't been hearing it. So get ready, because it's live. And things might get a little messy. Don't hold back, spit it out with Jason, yes sir. And now your host, Jason, yes sir.
Yeah, woo! Give it up, give it up! Yeah, baby! What is going on? What is happening, guys? Another brand new week, another episode for y'all we have here today. It's going to be a good one. It's going to be a great one. You're going to love it because we got the man, the legend himself, JJ in the building.
Thank you.
What's going on? It's been a while. Yeah, it's definitely been a while, but I can say you've been back for every single relaunch of Spit It Out. I want to say maybe this is, if you want to put it in season-wise, this could be, yeah, season three. So you made an appearance for season three. You know, you had to come on back. The people were asking.
Season 3 was this episode 4?
Oh, no, it's still episode 129, honey. Come on now.
I'm saying the third season.
Third season, yeah, season 3, episode 4, but no, it's actually episode 129. If you guys don't know, if you're a new listener here, Spit It Out has been a while.
That's why you brought me back.
For what?
Number 129.
You already know, I thought of you, of course. But if the new listeners that are just joining don't know, you're going to find out right now. This podcast has been around for a while. It's been around since 2015, to be exact, 7 years and counting. Not fully 7 years, though. It's been on hiatus a couple of times, came back, been off for about a year, came back again or so. So that's why we're saying season three, because it's the third time rolling around back. But it is the first time coming back with a new look, revamp, new intro, all of that goodness that you guys are actually witnessing. You've been hearing for the last couple of
years. I can tell. With your background, it's new and improved. I see that.
You know, we're doing big things out here in the Spit It Out studios. We got to step it up for season three. You know what I'm saying? We heard you was coming on back, so we had to make sure everything was looking perfection.
You went to the thrift store and bought those.
Hey, watch it now. I made them myself. Yeah, so it's been around for a while, this podcast. It's came back. It's went away again, came back again. But JJ did start off pretty much with the podcast, was been around for numerous of episodes. I would say you probably put in a good 75 episodes or so. So you were here for a while. The people got to know you and everything. You had a segment of your own and such. It's good, you know, always to have you back around. It's a good old time. So definitely going to have a great time this week and having you here. So thank you so much for coming on. Yeah, once again, wish you were here in the studio, but of course, can't have that happening because you're still over there in the Northeast, I want to say.
We just had the Northeaster out here.
That's what it was called, Northeast Eastern, yeah. Why don't they just call it a snowstorm anymore?
This one, I think they were calling it Bobby.
Bobby?
So there was Bobby.
With an I or a Y? Oh, okay. Okay.
So they're calling it Bobby, and a lot of like memes and stuff was Bobby from King of the Hill. I can't do the voice, but you catch the drift.
Yeah, I catch the drift. But when you said Bobby, the first Bobby I thought of was Bobby from Proud Family. That's actually coming back this month. Actually, speaking of it, February 23rd. Yeah. Also this month, Black History Month, so I think that's why it's also probably releasing in February. Happy Black History Month, everyone. It is the start when this episode comes up. It was when this is dropping. It is day number 2, and today is Groundhog's Day. Groundhog's Day. Obviously, a little too late. We don't know what happened because this episode's coming out today on the 2nd, and we recorded this previously. But what are you expecting?
Well, I'm saying, what is it? I always forget.
If it sees the shadow, 6 weeks more winter. If it doesn't see the shadow, 6 weeks less is closer to spring. Something like that, right? No, 2 weeks, not 6 weeks. It's 2 weeks, I think.
To me, it should be the other way around. Like, if he doesn't come out, he's hibernating because it's the winter.
Well, no matter. No, he comes out. He just is whether or not he sees his shadow. But he has to come out anyways.
And we had talked about this before because I was like, this is, remember?
It, was it like sounded episode, familiar, right? It probably was episode 12. Oh. But I'm going to predict, I'm going to go this year, 2022. I'm not sure what I went with last time, but I'm going to go ahead and predict that the groundhog is going to see his shadow. And I'm just, I'm not sure what it stands for, but I'm going to say the shadow stands for two more weeks of winter. So I'm going with that. Mm-hmm. Final answer, Regis. I'm going with sees the shadow, two more weeks of winter. What do you think?
I'm hoping he doesn't so spring can come because I need softball season to start up.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
Deal or no deal?
And I think actually last year, I think we had the prolong of winter, I believe last year.
Yes, yes. No, I do think it was that. That's why I was so kind of going with it again or so because I'm like, I think so. But I think it's to tell you the truth why I went to two more weeks of winter. Mm-hmm. I'm just thinking the whole global warming crisis we have going on.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm like, you know, it's getting hotter in the summer, colder in the winter, like extreme temperature. So that's why I was like, it's probably going to continue to be the winter. And then summer would just prolong itself as well because things are just getting shifted around.
Yeah.
So I guess we'll have to wait to see. You guys let us know what actually happened. This episode, leave us a comment on any of the socials or even on the website, jasonyester.com, and let us know what happened. Did the fucking bitch, the groundhog, did he see his shadow or not? What was going on? a groundhog, have we ever even seen a groundhog in person? Like in real life,
I
have
never
you?
Have. No,
yeah.
I never have.
I'm like, where do they even keep these things? In the ground. They literally only come out once a year, and that's it. That's the only time you hear about them.
I know, like I'm saying, like even like in the backyard, you know, like sometimes I do see holes in the background, in the backyard. But I don't know if it's a groundhog or if it's like a snake hole or if it's like,
or Shia LaBeouf holes. Out here, though, in the case there might be snow holes. There might be from snakes. Snakes could make holes and pop out of those sometimes, or so I heard. I've never seen one actually pop out before. Well, I've seen a snake pop out of a hole before, but that's another story. No, so what I do want to also, speaking of like the time of the year and everything, Groundhog's Day, all of that, tell me why I was walking Kai just before we recorded the podcast, and you would think we're in February now. Why the fuck you got your Christmas tree still up? Come on now. We've talked about this before, and when it's appropriate to take it down, and it's been time. We're in February now. Christmas tree should not be up or lit. One thing if it's up, but if you have it lit shining through the window, that's another thing, and that's what they had.
Well, at my job, they still have the Christmas tree up and they have all the lights all on.
Like decorating the whole place?
Yeah.
If January is over, they got to take that down. Because I was going to say, where else they do that? But I remember going to one of the Disney parks before. And they keep it up for like the month of January. And then after January, they take it down. And then they, I think, move into more of the Mardi Gras stuff for February. But yeah, now is the time to take it on down. You know, it's done and over with. We did the Three Kings as well, if you were waiting for that. But it's February.
It's time to gotta go.
Now,
I think they're saving it to March because that's like the theme that we have outside. It's all coming down in March, but still it's like that Christmas tree. You need to go and throw it over the into the woods. March. Or something.
That's mad. March madness. You see what I did there? I'm just on a roll today. Okay, so have you heard about The Wordle game everyone's talking about?
I think, is it like green, like boxes, green boxes?
Yeah, I haven't checked it out. I'm not sure. From what I've gathered and things surfacing on the socials and all of that, it's a word game, a daily word game that I guess you can only play like once a day, and it's a one word. I'm guessing it's like a puzzle that you have to figure out what that word is.
Once you figure it out, you get to the next step and stuff like that?
No. It's just one a day. That's it. It's like a vitamin, one a day. Yeah, there's nothing else to it, nothing like that. I guess you just got to wait till the next day to continue playing. But a lot of people I've seen going around talking about this, from, you know, big people to little people, like, as in I'm saying celebrity wise, like, not, you know, I've heard it around and all that. And I haven't gave in yet to actually check it out. You know, I'm not a one to jump the bandwagon or any type of wagon. That's not my type of transportation. But yeah, I'm just trying to see if it's whether or not if it's worth it. So I didn't know if you checked it out or heard about it.
No, I've heard about it. It's just, you know, it's another one of those things, another, what do I call it? Another fad going on.
What was the thing before? Oh, remember they had like Flappy Bird and all those other things?
Candy Crush. So I haven't seen actually now Flappy Bird, like on Instagram, people do the reels and all that stuff. Flappy Bird, people have been doing it like push-ups, but holding like almost in like a plank position. But like with the Flappy Bird going up like that, so you just gotta go like this, move like up and down. It's like moving your head and stuff like that. But it's really like working on your core and stuff like that. But they, you know, people always take it up to the next level.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness! You know what I just realized?
Never recorded.
No, we are, but I don't think I'm recording your video. Darn nabbit! I'm so sorry, people. First 10 minutes, you're not gonna be able to see. The one, the only, but you could still tune on in to
recording in progress.
YouTube.com/JasonYesSir and see the rest of the 10 minutes. Sorry, you're not going to be on the first 10 minutes video, but you'll be on the other side. I'm not going to re-record over. This is going well. It's going great. We're 10 minutes in and only 10 minutes more before we go to commercial. So sorry, you guys are going to just have to deal with it. You got to see me for the 10 minutes. Get over it. Okay. You know, the host. But now you see him here. Smile for the people, JJ. Lovely. All right. You've seen him. Okay. So, speaking of seeing, if you guys are watching youtube.com/JasonYesSir, you will see I have on this snaggy little hoodie here. Are these still available for purchase?
I believe those are sold out.
Oh, they are sold out. This was a creation of Faja, right? Faja?
Yes.
Okay. This isn't one of yours, but, it's his softball team that's been around for what? Like freaking 60 years. What is it?
You said 60?
Yeah, I don't know. It's been around for a while, right?
30 years since I turned 30. 30
years or so? Yeah. Oh, okay. 30 years. I was just double the amount of years over. I was close enough. Yeah, so it is his little, well, I wouldn't say little. It's his softball team that's been around for 30 years. And figured I'd sport it on this week's episode. I do wear this one. I would say out of all of the ones that he's made before and all that, I do wear this one probably the most.
It's comfy. Yeah, that was comfy.
It is. It's comfortable. Yeah. I think he would be proud, you know, since I never participated actually in the sports. At least I'm sporting the sport. But yeah, no, I do like it. I was just talking earlier to mom, and she had said that she was wearing hers earlier too as well.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now you're wearing.
I'm wearing the Florida one of.
Young Stars with a Z. Okay, so this is the Gen Z generation. Just kidding. No, but that's also the Youngins decided to take the torch and continue the softball legacy. Yep. And
there's this one was in Florida the design. And one in Connecticut.
And the difference is just the S to Z, but it's all basically the same stuff. The colors have changed. But also, too, back then, the colors have changed around in different colorways all previously before, so it's not like the first time it's been switched up. But wow, what a coincidence that we both had, like, it wasn't planned at all. If people were watching this, they'd be like, come on, guys.
You got the best
is this promo? They'd be like, yeah, is this free promo?
It's funny though because where you're at, I have the hoodie for that, and then you have the hoodie where I'm at. Like, you know, you don't have
vice versa. One. True, yeah. Down Florida, Connecticut, and we're wearing the... Vice versa. Definitely wasn't planned. Definitely. So speaking of challenges, everything that we were saying about the Wordle and all that, you know, we love ourselves a good challenge, or do we? Because I know you got pretty strong opinions on some challenges and some things that go viral around, and not always the one to participate in them. But actually, I think we're going to say that after when we come back from commercial break. We'll hold on because I think the conversation is probably going to take longer than expected and what we have time left for. Yeah. So we'll talk about that once we return from commercial. But before we actually go to commercial and everything, I do want to get into we don't talk much about I try not to at least talk much about too much of the celebrity news. I like to have more conversations going. If celebrity things pop mm-hmm. up, mm-hmm. if, you know, pop culture things pop up and that's what the conversation leads to, it's fine. Don't care, whatever. It's just, you know, wherever the conversation pretty much leads. But it's not a pop culture show, a news show, anything like that. It's more so we're just having conversations here. So don't take anything too seriously. But with that mm-hmm. said, if I'm going to talk about one celebrity, definitely going to have to talk about who?
Rihanna.
Definitely Rihanna now. So we all, if you don't know, where the hell have you been? Rihanna has broken the internet.
It's not her water yet.
Not her water yet. Definitely not. I'm not even sure how far along she is, but we did see, if you guys haven't seen, where the fuck have you been? Rihanna posted a picture of her and ASAP strutting their stuff on the, it looked like it was NYC, right? On the NYC yeah. streets?
Yeah, it was in New York, and then I came across something yesterday, or maybe earlier today, and they were like, why Rihanna's walking around with her bottom of her pants? Remember, like, in school, when you used to go, and they would drag it, it used to come with,
off the ground? Dirt. Yeah.
And it was all like that. Her pants are all, like, dirty and dingy and everything.
And there's, yeah, because it's all cold and, like, snowy over there, too, right? What is the picture had snow? Was it recent?
Yeah, I think it was probably. I think that was probably like on Friday or something. I want to say like around that. Or I don't think it was.
But I'm saying like I know it was recent, like posters, but I don't know if it was recent, as in like the picture was taken recent and then posted, or it was held onto a while and then released.
Oh yeah,
that's you, know now, you could kind of tell like the weather wise.
Yeah, it was not that long ago. I will say. Yeah. If not, it could have been over the weekend or maybe like a couple of weeks, but it's obviously when it was cold. And then I actually was saying to mom the other day, I was like, mom, like, okay, I get it, you know, showing the pregnancy, but I was like, it's cold out there. She needs to have her shirt on.
We got to cover this baby up. This baby needs to be at all safe at all costs, especially out there in the NYC streets. But Robin, Rihanna Fenty is going to be having a baby.
Name was Robin.
Robin, yes, Robin with a Y. You know, we have something in common. I always knew there was some kind of type of spark there. What I was going to say, though. Did I see this coming? I don't know if I more so seen this coming. They've been together for a while now. I do know mm-hmm. that. She hasn't been much in the limelight. She has, but hasn't, I would say. She's taken a step back away from the limelight, but still there. She still has her presence. No one's forgotten about her.
Yeah,
but
I mean, definitely from music, she's definitely stepped away. But
she's still making it through. While all her other companies, that she's a billionaire, you know that, right?
Yeah. Well, didn't she just now her stuff? Well, she's gonna have her own store. I seen that. Which that's a big one.
A flagship store, like a brick and mortar for Savage Fenty, her lingerie line and like loungewear.
That and then isn't her stuff, or has it already been like in Sephora and all that stuff?
Yeah, well, Fenty, the Fenty Beauty, I think that was it. Maybe Sephora is, or one of those, makeup stores and all, but of course on her website. So she no longer has, though, the Fenty line that she no longer has.
Oh, okay.
That she came out with the clone that was like the designer line, the first like designer line to come around since mm-hmm. forever. That was, you know, the same as like Louis Vuitton, Gucci, all that type of stuff.
Yep,
she does, she did stop that. That only lasted about a year. But everything else has taken off, and she dropped the next day after the pregnancy photo. She dropped a promo for Fenty Beauty. Yeah, that's why people were like, ooh, smart move there. But yeah, hey, if you're going to, you know, get all the buzz already the day before, might as well now drop a promo for your new product that's about to come out. And I think it was like lip liners or lipstick or something like that. She knows what she's doing.
Was it in red?
There was one, yeah, and it was like different shades, okay, but one of them was red. I think the one she was pitting on, and they were wearing like kind of coats and stuff.
Well, but was she like this?
With the red? No, she was facing directly to the camera the whole time. If you guys didn't know what was just going on, if you're only listening, JG did his best model move. I think he was watching a lot of America's Next Top Model.
Do
they still show it? I don't think so. No, I think Tyra gave it up. She retired. She went to bed. But I was just like, oh, okay, go ahead, Rihanna. Definitely going to, you know, stick around. That's going to be, because they asked for these photos of these celebrity kids, like, you know, the new baby when they're born. They try to sell it to the highest paying magazine and stuff.
I
can only imagine what, because, you know, a lot of times now when the kid's born, they don't try to release the photo right away. They're not showing a photo of them in the hospital. They're waiting, you know. So who can only imagine? I could easily, I'm sure, like $2 million could be offered just for that photo, just to post to be the first post with it. But like I said, Rihanna's a smart woman. She knows what to do, and I'm sure she'll make the decision when that time comes for how to release
it. About her line, her clothing line, like the clothing line and the makeup and all that stuff. But how about you? Would you buy anything from her? Like, because she does have men's stuff.
Yeah, no, definitely. Savage Fenty, she does have a line for men and everything loungewear, like I said, and silky rolls, boxes, all that to get you a little sexy on.
The one thing I would try just the box, like the boxer briefs and stuff, because I like that material way better than, you know, the old fashioned.
See, I'm boxer. Not a fan of silk though. I feel like silk makes me more one. So sweat, but I still get it. You know, I gotta support my girl Rihanna. You know what I'm saying? I don't care. I'll buy whatever it is, even if it's not for me. I'll still buy it. I might have to buy. Check out that lipstick, the red. I think I can pull off red. I think I'm gonna get that. Let me add that to my cart right now. Siri, no. I don't even have an iPhone.
You don't have Apple.
All right, we is getting messy over here. Let's go to commercial break. We'll be right back. We still got more things to go. We got JJ in the building, of course. Gotta love it. Don't go nowhere. You ain't going nowhere. I'm not going nowhere. And your people listening better not be going nowhere.